Hello everyone, it's Sarah with Spicy Pinecone, and a few weeks ago I was contacted by BrambleBerry. Anne Marie has a new book out called Pure Soapmaking, and it teaches you how to make soap naturally, also to color it and fragrance it. They offered to send me a kit to recreate one of the recipes from the book, so I'm going to be sharing that with you as well. Now, I've read the book in its entirety, and there are a few key points that I wanted to talk about. Maybe not a few, maybe a little bit more than a few. I marked quite a few pages on here. I'm not going to take you through the entire book. This is something I think that if you guys are interested in, you should purchase it. But one of my favorite things about this is when you open it up, you'll see that it has a spiral binding, which allows the book to lay flat. It's a really nice feature to have if you're working on a recipe and you don't want to be fighting with a book that keeps closing on you. Okay, so I said I'm not going to take you through every single page, but I thought I'd kind of give you a general overview of each chapter. Chapter one is more about science and safety of soap making. It's written for a beginner. However, people who have made batches of soap before, they can also benefit from that information as well. Chapter two is more about gear that you're going to need, protective gear, molds, measurement, mixing, just things that you're going to need in the course of making a regular batch of soap. Chapter three will take you through the process of making an entire batch of soap from start to finish. Now, chapter four is all about oils, and it doesn't cover every single oil that is available to you. However, it's a very nice general overview of oils and their attributes. And at the very end of this chapter is a frequently asked question section. Now, chapter five is all about additives, questions that you may want to ask yourself before you add anything to your soap. It gives an overview of common additives used in batches of soap, how to color your soap, and also a section on infusions. One part of this that I really did like is there is a little chart of soaps that have been colored naturally, and it shows them fresh and also aged 5 months. So you see the freshly cut version, and then 5 months later, if it's going to darken or go through any changes. Chapter six covers scenting your soap with essential oils, how you can blend them, and also essential oil safety. Now, chapter seven is about designing your own recipe. You may want to take a recipe from the book and change it up, run it through a lye calculator, and you'll find that switching an oil can change how your soap performs in the end. You can also change your soap by having different water additives, such as replacing part of your lye water with coffee, milk, juice. That's covered in chapter seven as well. Now, chapter eight is where she begins to make the soap, and you can follow along. Chapter eight is more of a kind of a beginner chapter. It has solid colors, how to change textures in your bar for like a honeycomb effect, using dividers, layering, and just basic beginner techniques that if you're just starting off, they're very simple to use. When you progress into chapter nine, then it starts to get a little bit more advanced, and there are more advanced swirl techniques. There's embeds, ombre, faux funnels, layered swirls, how to do a reverse stamp on a soap where instead of having your stamp recessed, you actually have the stamp raising the soap. And that's a really, really neat technique that you'll find from Auntie Clara. Now in chapter 10, the soap seemed to be very vibrant, and also Anne Marie seemed to have a lot of fun playing around with the recipes. You'll find more advanced techniques such as coated embeds, multiple embeds, double pours, negative space, just a bunch of different things that you can try to come up with something that is uniquely your own. Okay, so this is the soap that I'm going to be making with the kit that BrambleBerry sent. This is the Aloe Vera Hanger Swirl soap.